Back to basics, coding contrast. So this questioner said she saw a YouTube clip of me explaining administration of contrast and made it look much easier with the chart. Oh, yes, it is. I'm unable to locate it at the web address on the slide. Is it still available? I'm studying for my CPC, and I'm finding the YouTube clips very helpful. I'm a verbal learner and appreciate this resource. What I did is I just took a typical code grouping that deals with contrast for radiology. So, and I'm going to show you the chart in a minute, but just I wanted to kind of lead up to it. So when you look at these type of codes, normally for CTs or CTAs, they're normally going to be, the first code is going to say without contrast. The second code is going to say with contrast. And the third one is going to say without followed by with. Now, when I worked for CodeRyte, it was very heavy into radiology stuff. We would, they said the old way of saying it, that the radiologists would say it, is a without was considered a dry study, and a with was considered a wet. And this third one they called a wet-dry. So it was like for comparison purposes. So as coders, we need to know, when are we allowed to code the indented codes, the with contrast codes? So these two we consider with contrast. And there's very specific guidelines on when we can do that and how to code it. The main thing that you have to remember for contrast is oral contrast and rectal contrast for coding purposes do not count. Okay, I'll say that again. Oral and rectal do not count. Okay, so it's just something you have to get into your brain. There's no one place to write it, which 90% of the tips I give for CPT, you can find a spot in the CPT book to write that cue. But in this case, it's something you just need to commit to memory. Oral and rectal contrast do not count. You will always code the top code, the one that says without. And it's so doesn't feel right because I'm reading in the note it says contrast. But oral and rectal are coded as without contrast, okay? Just think of the work involved. You know, really for oral, the patients drink it themselves and, you know, giving an enema doesn't require that much skill. But when you start dealing with needles and giving injections of contrast and dye, then you're dealing with, you know, some higher risk and therefore more money is deserved. So keep this kind of pattern in mind. And this is a CT of the abdomen. Now, here's the page from my CPT manual with all my notes on contrast. And the actual guidelines start here. Let me see if I can make it a little bit bigger. So here's where the guidelines start, lower left-hand corner. This is page 407 for the 2015 version, administration of contrast materials. Now, if you've been on a lot of these webinars, you've heard me say, I'm a very visual learner. I see paragraphs of stuff like this, and it's just like, wah, wah, wah. It doesn't make sense to me. I have to break it down into a visual, and this is an example of me doing it. So I'm going to show you the written way, and if you did what I did when I first read this the first 100 times, I went, what are they saying? So it says, the phrase with contrast used in the codes for procedures performed using contrast for imaging enhancement represents contrast material administered. These are the only ways. Intravascularly, so that's going into a vessel. Intraarticularly, that's going into a joint. Or intrathecally, that's going into the spine. Okay? These are what I affectionately call needlework. Okay? Now this next paragraph says for intraarticular injection in the joint, use the appropriate joint injection code. Ah, so this is letting you code something in addition to the radiology codes that we just looked at. Okay, it's a permission statement in the guidelines. If radiographic arthrography is performed, also use the arthrography supervision and interpretation code for the appropriate joint, which includes fluoroscopy. Okay, now I'm starting to glaze over, right? If CT or MR arthrography are performed without radiographic arthrography, okay, so now they're talking about joint studies with just an x-ray, or a joint study with a CT, or a joint study with an MR, okay, there's all those three different types. Use the appropriate joint injection code and the appropriate CT or MR code. And then this is the permission statement. You can use the indented with contrast or without followed by with. and the appropriate imaging guidance code for needle placement. So now we get to code a code for the needle work. Okay? Now, to finish it off, the next paragraph, for spine examination using CT, MR, MRA with contrast includes intrathecal or intravascular injection. For intrathecal injection, so this is the spine again, use also these two codes. So this is a permission statement for additional codes that we can use and get additional reimbursement for the physician. And then the next paragraph says injection of intravascular contrast, that's vein or artery, is part of the with contrast. So they're not going to give you any extra codes. They're going to let you use the with indented codes, which has a higher RVU, more pay. Okay. The last paragraph, oral and or rectal contrast administration alone does not qualify as a study with contrast for coding purposes. Okay. All right, so this is the chart. I know it's tipped sideways, so I'm going to scroll down and show you one that I printed up. And you can get this link, and we'll have it in the slides at the end, but if someone wants to paste that into the chat, it's cco.us/administration-of-contrast, okay? And I took all that want paragraphs, and I just did it this way. If it's oral contrast, the study type would be without contrast, that top code. And no, you can't code an extra code, and no, you can't code fluoroscopy. Rectal, same thing. Intravascularly, you can code the study type as with contrast. That's what they let you do to get that higher RVU. Intraarticularly, where they do an x-ray of the joint to get that needle in just right, you get to code a with contrast code, one of the indented ones, and you get to code a joint injection code, but the fluoroscopy is included. You can't bill that separate. If you do intraarticularly of the joint using CT or MR, not x-ray, you code the contrast, the indented contrast codes, you get to code a joint injection code, but this time you get to code fluoroscopy separately. It's not bundled in. And then finally, intrathecally for the spine, with contrast, you can use one of these two codes, 61055 or 62284, to get credit for that needlework, and you're also allowed to code the fluoroscopy separately. Okay, so I love this chart, and what I have my students do is handwrite it into that page of the guidelines so it looks like mine, and then they can just use this when they're taking the exam or for real-world coding. So hopefully that helps.
Do you need more medical certification training? Go to www.cco.us. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for updates.